Hey Morningstar, Tuesday was Veterans Day, a day our country sets aside to give homage and respect to those who've served in our nation's armed forces. And so a couple days now after the fact, I just want to take a second and truly salute those who've voluntarily signed up to protect the freedoms that I so enjoy and often, unfortunately, just take for granted every day. Hey, unlike many nations who conscript their citizenry to serve, in the United States today, we have a volunteer army, and those who choose serving as a vocation are often motivated by one of three general reasons. First, hey, it might just be a job, simply a way to earn a living. Or second of all, they have a sense of duty, a sense of obligation to serve their country, maybe because a father or a mother or a grandparent did. Or finally, maybe they're doing it out of a sense of gratitude, being appreciative and thankful for living in a country that affords all of us, citizens and even foreigners and aliens, countless unprecedented freedoms. Those second two reasons actually have a great deal of application here in the church, especially when it comes to giving, offering our time and our talent and our treasure. In case you haven't noticed, the church doesn't conscript people. We're pretty much a volunteer organization. Outside of a small percentage of paid staff, no one serves for a paycheck. Rather, the motivation is either duty or gratitude, or often some combination of both of these. Certainly, there's some duty, some expectation involved. We talked about that this weekend when we looked at Jesus' parable of the talents. God has gifted us, all of us, in incredible ways. Why? So we can use those gifts and talents to further God's purposes, to help Jesus build his church and bring the kingdom of heaven on earth as it is in heaven. As Jesus says, there will be a day where all of us will have to give an account to our heavenly Father for how we've stewarded the talents he's blessed and entrusted us with. Hey, but friends, it's not all duty. At some point, duty runs dry, and we all get to the point where we come to see all the freedoms that God's blessed us with in Jesus Christ is something that we could never repay, all the countless unprecedented freedoms that we have in Christ, and we want to gratefully offer ourselves back to Him, that we wouldn't take for granted Jesus' ultimate sacrifice to forgive our sins and give us abundant eternal life. So, how do you need to turn the page? Is it this first step of duty to take a step because God has called you to? Or have you been serving out of responsibility and duty too long and now you've grown to the point in your understanding of God's grace and your faith where you can give back to God out of a sense of gratitude for what Jesus, as well as those who've gone before you, have given and sacrificed? Hey, this past Sunday, after service, I was on the treadmill over at the gym, and one of the TV monitors was showing Saving Private Ryan. Great show, right? And it struck me once again, the lengths that squadron of soldiers went to in order to rescue a private, not a five-star general, but a lowly private. A private that none of them knew. Several members of the rescue squadron made the ultimate sacrifice, lost their lives in order to seek and save this young man's life and return him to his mother, who had already lost all her other sons in the war. Friends, that's who Jesus was, and that's who we are called to be as his church, folks who've enlisted to serve a higher mission and purpose to seek and to save the lost. Persons we might not even know, persons who may not have much rank and privilege in society. So hey, as we honor our veterans this week, as we should, let's think about the one who gave his all for us. And then let's turn the page and ask ourselves how duty and gratitude inform our response to the mission of building God's kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Hey, as always, Morningstar, be the church this week, and I'll see you in worship this weekend. God bless you.